have to do what businesses and families do. We've got to cut out the things we don't need to pay for the things we do.
And that cut out things they don't need, but they still make investments in the things that are going to make sure we win the future. And that's
got to cut out the equivalence of eating out and vacations. I know
even as we cut out things that we can afford to do without, we have a responsibility to invest in those areas that will have the biggest impact in our future. And that's especially true when it comes to education.
What the Republicans right now are saying is, number one, they can't agree to any increases in taxes, which means we'd have to cut out of that $4 trillion, all of it would come from education, transportation, areas that I think are critical for our long-term future.
But you're not going to cut out the college fund for your kid.
Let's cut out waste and fraud in healthcare programs like Medicare. And at the same time, let's make modest adjustments so that Medicare is still there for future generations.
It's a plan that lives by the same rules that families do. We've got to cut out things that we can't afford to do in order to afford the things that we really need. And if we're serious about paying for it, then yes, we've got to cut out programs that don't work. We cut out the middleman. We've got to cut out spending we don't need, building on the $1 trillion of spending cuts we've already made. And we said, why don't we just give the loans directly to the students, cut out the banks, then we can help more students.
My main concern is that I know a lot of stories of people who are LGBT who come out to their parents, and their parents are supporting them financially for the college. And when they come out, their parents cut out that support.
We're going to spend some time here today talking about all the efforts that have been made by many of these cabinet secretaries to streamline operations, to cut out waste, to improve performance, to improve customer satisfaction.
So I do believe we should cut out programs that we don't need.
We've got to continue to cut out waste. And banks should be making a profit on what they do, but not off the backs of students. Well, it's true that in part because we've expanded Pell Grants and we cut out the bank middleman on student loans so that we could give more student loans, that a lot of young people are able to finance college that they couldn't do before. But, well, why don't we just cut out the middleman, give the loans directly to the students, and then we can expand it for millions of students, which is exactly what we did.
And our concern there was that China was the 800-pound gorilla, and if we allowed them to set trade rules out there, American businesses and American workers were going to be cut out.
But that's not what was possible in our democracy. In the same way that Social Security, when it first started, was a meagerly program providing benefits to just a few people and historically cut out for purely racist reasons, domestic servants or sharecroppers or what have you. And then over time,